Welcome, my friends, for this live stream, Hope and Healing. This Hope and Healing is every week, and I receive a special guest from around the world. Today, I have a friend who is coming from the northeast of Europe, close to Asia, where it's very cold. He's from Siberia, and I will introduce him in a few minutes. Before that, I would love to read with you something that God spoke to me very early this morning. Actually, this morning, I woke up around 4 a.m. At 4:30, I was up and I started to pray and to read the Bible as I do every day, putting my hope and trust in the Lord. And that's the purpose of this Hope and Healing, is not to speak about a religion or a denomination, but it's really to speak about this wonderful God, our Creator, and in Him alone we can find hope. I would love to read with you in Psalm 145, which declare this one, 145 verse 5. My Bible, my online Bible is just blocked. Let me see to open it. Here we are, Psalm 145, verse 15. The Bible said, "The eyes of all look to you in hope, and you give them their food as they need it." I really believe, my friends, as you are watching from around the world, first of all, I want to welcome you. I would love, like I do in every life, it would be wonderful that you can go to the chat and you can write a few things, starting by telling us where you are from, where are you watching from, and I would love really to welcome you. I have the chat, the comments, so I can see that, and I want to say thanks so much to all my team who is doing an amazing job, especially Marisa, Patrick, and Gabrielle. Is just fantastic to work with you. So I want to encourage you just to say hi and to say where you are watching from, but also I would love really to encourage you to turn your eyes upon God, upon Jesus Himself, where there is hope. And He promised you, and that's for today, He will give you food that you need. Maybe your food that you need today, it's healing. I have a good news. We are going to pray for the sick and you will be healed. So many people getting healed. Every week I'm doing this Hope and Healing. The next week I will be with George Karl from Germany. And every week I'm doing that. Just go to my website. That's actually the possibility. If you go to my website, you will receive the email, the information, but also I want to send you the free weekly hope inspiration. So jeanluctraxel.org, that's my personal website, and you will receive for free this weekly hope inspiration. So welcome, my friend, Mary from France, Angelica from Torino, Italy. That's fantastic. Welcome Gertie from Austria, people from Switzerland, France. I'm sure that there is Russian people because I just saw some Russian text. And actually, we are going to speak English and Russian on this show as Pastor Vladimir is going to join me in a few minutes. So again, welcome. Welcome Cécile from France. That's amazing to see you. I hope, believe that the Lord is with you in this time of confinement, and He will never forsake us. We are also praying especially for the American friends, as today it's a very special day. And actually, I see people from the U.S. who are watching. Well, welcome, Sherry from the U.S. God bless you, and we are going to pray for you and your country. Bienvenue à Sophie from Moselle. Hello, Soren from Sweden. That's fantastic. So many countries are watching today, and we are very grateful for that. Also, I would love that you can do something that I will do directly now. Why don't you go to your Facebook? You can go to my page or IHM page, but you can go Jean-Luc Traxel Ministries. And then as you go there, like I'm doing right now, you will see the direct, this live things. And what will be wonderful is that you share it, that your friends, your family, your neighbor may hear today the gospel. The gospel is not about religion, it's about God, it's about Jesus, and there is hope in him. So share the good news. That's so important. If you are a Christian, just go, or if not, just go to the page and share it, share the life, that others may hear the gospel, but also, as we are going to pray for the sick, that they can recover and receive their healings. So welcome to all of you, people from Canada, Ovidio from Canada, bless you. Sarah from Missouri in the US, bless you, Sarah. Welcome, Anna from Toulouse. That's one thing I will say in French. Sorry for that. Mais pour les francophones, ce soir à 19h, ne manquez pas le live Espoir et Guérison où j'aurai une invitée spéciale qui est médecin et psychiatre et qui prie pour les malades. Ça va être extraordinaire. Donc, n'oubliez pas, invitez les amis, rejoignez-nous ce soir à 19h et ça sera en français avec une invitée spéciale qui est médecin, docteur et psychiatre et qui prie pour les malades. What I was just saying is tonight I have a live in French and I have a special guest who is a medical doctor and a psychiatric doctor who is praying for the sick. And we're going to have that in French. So God bless you again for all those people who are watching from UK. Welcome Faye, welcome George from Marseille, Elena from Switzerland in Payern. That's wonderful. I'm so blessed to see you all today. And again, if you have not done yet, share it that others can hear the gospel. Without waiting, it's my great joy and privilege to welcome Pastor Vladimir Ashev, who is a bishop and senior pastor of one of the most dynamic churches in Russia, the Christian Life Church. One of the missions of this church is to spread and plant new missionaries, churches throughout Russia and abroad. Vladimir is the deputy chief bishop of Russia's largest union, deputy bishop for the Siberian Federal District, and director of the Department for International Affairs. He is also the leader of the Russia Shall Be Saved movement, part of Europe Shall Be Saved, which creates a very powerful movement of God that unites all denominations in order for Russia to be saved. He ignites the hearts of the people and refreshes them. Incredible healing miracles take place in this service. And today, miracles and healing will happen. I want to welcome my very good friend, Vladimir Ashev from Krasnoyarsk in Siberia, Russia. Vladimir, are you here?
Да, мы здесь.
Yes, we are here.
Hello, Jean-Luc.
Welcome and so much honor and blessed to have you on this live today. Pastor Vladimir, we can see you have the smile, but how do you get the smile as we are living a challenging season where there is so many situation, challenging situation? How do you get the smile?
Но Бог-то никогда не изменился.
Well, God never changes.
Он всегда и во веки тот же.
He is the same always.
Проходя различные ситуации,
as we go through different situations,
нам нужно просто их проходить.
We just need to go through this.
Это мы не должны там оставаться.
We should not stay there.
В Библии говорится,
the Bible says,
даже если мы проходим долиной плача,
even if we go through the valley of death,
долина плача — это не наша цель.
The valley of weeping is
наша
not our goal.
Благие поля.
Our destination is good fields.
И добрые воды.
And good waters.
И поэтому там говорится, проходя, проходи.
That's why it says, as you pass through, pass through.
И поэтому мы все равно пройдем всякую пандемию.
So we will go through this pandemic.
И Царство Божие не изменилось, чтобы спасать и исцелять.
And the kingdom of God doesn't change. It
и поэтому
still
мы
saves.
Живем в Царстве Божьем.
So we are in the kingdom of God.
И поэтому радуемся.
That's why we rejoice.
That's amazing. I love your smile. But Pastor Vladimir, there are many people who are watching. They are not Christian and they don't believe in Jesus, or maybe they question, who is this Jesus? And why Christianity is better or different than Buddhism or Islam or another religion, or maybe God doesn't exist. What you will say to these people?
Для меня Иисус – это реальная личность.
For me, Jesus is a real person.
И Он живой.
And He's alive.
Потому что в мою жизнь Он пришел.
Because He came into my life.
Я родился в коммунистической стране,
I was born in a communistic country,
где мы отрицали всякую религию.
Where we denied any religion.
И я думал,
And I thought,
что кто-то что-то есть,
that there is, or there was somebody,
но так далеко
or something,
от нас,
so
пока
us.
Я лично не встретился с Иисусом.
I thought this way until I met Jesus.
Почему христианство отличается от всех других религий?
Why is Christianity different from other religions?
Потому что оно несет жизнь.
Because it carries life.
Потому что никто не сможет изменить человека, кроме Иисуса.
Because no one can change a person. Only Jesus.
Так Иисус пришел в мою жизнь.
This way Jesus came into my life.
Я не верил в Него.
I did not believe in
Но
him.
Когда я встретился с Ним,
But when I met him,
я понял, что Он живой.
I realized he's alive.
Он не какая-то религия.
He's not a religion.
Он не какие-то обряды и действия.
He is not customs or some actions.
А что Он реальные взаимоотношения.
But he is real relationship.
Никто не воскрес из мертвых.
No one has resurrected from the dead.
Но Иисус это сделал.
But Jesus has done
и почему
it.
Он это сделал?
And why has he done it?
Потому что для тебя и для меня.
He has done it for you and for me.
Он настолько жаждал отношений с людьми.
He was so hungry to have
relationship with people. Что смерть его не могла удержать.
That death could not hold him.
Все другие лидеры,
All other
которые
leaders,
заявляют о религии, своей религии,
who would, declare their
никто
religion.
Не воскрес.
No, none of them has
Но
been
Иисус
resurrected.
Воскрес из мертвых.
But Jesus has been resurrected from the dead for us.
Чтобы быть с нами.
To be with us.
Чтобы общаться с нами.
To fellowship with us.
И когда я это увидел,
And when I saw this,
я сказал, Иисус,
I said, Jesus,
я хочу знать Тебя.
I want to know you.
Я знал о Тебе.
I knew about you.
Но не знал Тебя.
But I didn't know you.
Я знал, что есть церкви какие-то.
I knew that there are some churches.
Я даже путал христиане от крестьян.
I didn't even know the difference Christians and some farmers that sound the same in Russian.
У нас потому что то же самое слово почти. И поэтому я когда пережил его присутствие,
So when I experienced his presence,
я встретился с ним.
I met him.
Я думал, как я могу его увидеть.
I was thinking, how could I see him?
Я тогда бы я поверил, раньше задавал вопрос такой себе.
I was asking myself a question, or I would say to myself, if I see, I would believe.
Но потом я осознал одну вещь.
But then I realized one
thing. Ты не можешь видеть ветер.
You cannot see the wind.
Ты можешь только чувствовать ветер.
You can feel the wind.
Ты можешь видеть проявление ветра.
You can see the effect of the wind.
Но ветер ты не видишь.
But you cannot see the wind.
И я понял, что я не вижу Бога.
And I realized I cannot see God.
Потому что если бы я увидел, может быть, со своими грехами, я просто сгорел.
Maybe if I saw God with my own sins, I would burn.
Но я могу его чувствовать.
But I could feel God.
Я могу видеть его проявление.
I can see his manifestation.
Когда он исцеляет больных.
When he heals people.
Когда он меняет жизни людей.
When he changes people's lives.
Из бывшего из наркомана становится человек, который служит ему.
When a former drug addict becomes a person who serves to drug addicts.
Алкоголики меняют свои жизни.
Alcoholics' lives changes.
Преступники меняют свои
Criminals
жизни.
Criminals change their lives.
Когда они встречаются лицом к лицу
When
с Богом.
When they meet God face to face.
И я увидел это проявление.
And I saw this manifestation.
И для меня все вопросы отпали.
And all my questions didn't matter.
И поэтому я понимаю, что Бог, Он живой.
That's why I realized God
Он реальный.
Is alive. He is real.
И поэтому я могу говорить с Ним.
And I can talk to him.
Общаясь с Ним,
By communicating
я
with
наполняюсь.
I get filled.
Я изменяюсь.
I get changed.
Религия всегда вокруг да около.
Religion is always around
И
you.
Она никогда не дает ответа.
It never gives you answers.
Она заставляет тебя двигаться, что ты можешь какими-то усилиями что-то достичь.
It makes you move so that you could gain something with your efforts.
Но наш Бог,
But our God,
Он прорвался через стены религии,
he broke through the walls
чтобы
of religion,
лично познакомиться.
So he can meet you personally.
Мы из России.
We are from Russia.
У нас православная страна.
We have an Orthodox country.
Хоть мы и были коммунистами,
And even though we were communists,
но иногда нас водили в православную церковь.
Sometimes we were taken to the Orthodox Church.
У нас были иконы.
We had icons.
Потому что глубоко в душе мы где-то верили.
Because deep inside of our soul we did believe.
И мое представление о церкви было такое.
And my imagination of the church or my picture of the church was like this.
Икона.
Icon.
И она меня спасет.
And this icon would change me.
Но когда я пережил личную встречу с Иисусом.
But when I experienced personal encounter with Jesus.
Я просто почувствовал, что он рядом.
I could feel that he is near. He is right next to me.
Понял.
And I realized,
что мне не нужны ни иконы.
That I do not need icons.
Никакие образы.
I do not need any images.
Что мне нужен он лично.
I need him.
Потому что я же, когда разговариваю со своими друзьями,
because when I talk to my friends,
я же не разговариваю через фотографию с ними.
I don't talk to their picture.
Я вживую с ними
I
говорю.
Talk to them personally.
И вот для меня Бог открылся таким образом.
And this is how God revealed himself.
Я вживую с ним стал говорить.
I could communicate with him personally.
И поэтому
that's why
Бог, он реальный для меня.
God is real to me.
И он живой.
And he's alive.
И после этого я понял, я хочу посвятить ему свою
and
жизнь.
After this, I realized that I want to commit my life to him.
Я хочу близких отношений.
I want to have close relationships.
Я хочу знать его.
I want to know him.
И вот так моя жизнь начала строиться.
And this is how my life began to develop.
Вообще по-другому.
In a different direction.
Учителя
my teachers
говорили о мне,
they talked about
что
me.
Мне нужно сидеть в тюрьме.
They told me that I would be in prison.
Они все пророчествовали
they would all prophesy
мне об
to
этих
me
вещах.
About such things.
Но когда я пережил Иисуса,
but when I experienced
я пришел
Jesus,
к ним.
I came to my teachers.
Они сказали, ты другой.
And they told me, you're
что
different.
С тобой произошло?
What happened to you?
Я говорю, Бог изменил мою жизнь. Мои ценности поменялись. У меня желание проснулось. Помогать людям. Служить людям. И рассказывать, что Иисус – самая реальная и живая личность. И это не религия. Это жизнь. Реальные отношения. Вот что меня подвигло.
This is what made me move in this.
Thanks so much. And my friend, if you just join us, you are live on Hope and Healing. It's a weekly live stream. Every week I have a special guest. We are sharing about God, about the Creator, where there is hope, not only for our religion life, but for our real life, and also is the one who healed the sick, and soon, in a few minutes, we are going to pray for the sick. Also, I would love to say, if you want healing today, you can start to write on the chat what you are expecting from God, because in a few minutes, we are going to pray for you, and we would love to pray also specifically. Also, I have the great joy and willing to offer you something for free. I want to share you a gift. A few months ago, God spoke to me very clearly that this is a season where he wants to release hope in our life, as the devil is trying to destroy, to bring calamity with this pandemic and bringing sadness, fear. People are losing their job, losing a lot of money. It's a challenging season, and I really want to tell to all of you, we are praying for you. You are not alone. God is with you. He will never forsake you. And in this pandemic, God spoke to me, said, Jean-Luc, I want to release hope to this generation. And that's the reason every week I'm writing word coming from heaven full of hope for your life. If you want to receive that for free, you can register to my website, jeanluctraxel.org, and receive it in English and French. Not in Russian yet. I hope it will come very soon. But every week you can receive freely this hope and hope inspiration. If you go to register to jeanluctraxel.org, it's like a short teaching, a word of inspiration with a specific song full of hope. But also there is a quote, there is a prayer, an example of beautiful prayer, and healing testimony. So God bless you. Pastor Vladimir, you were sharing your testimony and that was so beautiful. But some people who are watching, they say, I'm Christian, but I don't know this Jesus. I don't know this God the way you are speaking. Maybe they are Catholic or Protestant evangelical, or maybe Orthodox, but they don't know this Jesus. And maybe others, they are don't know this Jesus really, but they say they would love to know Jesus. What do they need to do to have a real relation with Jesus?
Однажды я тоже задавался таким вопросом.
Once I was asking myself the same question.
Я не знаю его лично.
I don't know him personally.
Как я могу познакомиться?
How can I meet him?
Я не хочу просто в религию верить.
I do not just want to believe in religion.
И один человек мне сказал.
And one person told me.
Не оставайся равнодушным.
Don't stay indifferent.
Бог есть дух, и он дышит где хочет.
God is the spirit, and he breathes where he wants.
Когда идет поклонение.
During worship.
Или молитва.
Or during prayer.
Ты не просто стой, как один из обрядов.
Don't just stay still as one of the religious
customs. А попробуй войти в это все.
But try to enter this.
И я помню первый раз в своей жизни.
And I remember the first time in my life.
Я встал вот так.
I stood up like this.
И сказал, Господи.
And I said, Lord.
Я не знаю тебя.
I don't know you.
Но я хочу тебя знать лично.
But I want to know you personally.
Пожалуйста, прояви себя.
Please manifest yourself.
И Дух Святой так сильно сошел.
And Holy Spirit came on me.
Я никогда такого не переживал в своей жизни.
I had never experienced this before.
Я был как будто пьяный.
I was like if I was drunk.
Я прямо почувствовал на своем теле.
I could feel it in my body.
Его присутствие.
His presence.
И я сказал, Господи,
and I said, Lord,
если ты такой,
if this is who you are,
мне это нравится.
I like it.
И с этих пор
and since that time,
я всегда чувствую его присутствие.
I could always feel his presence.
Когда мне тяжело,
when I go through hard times,
я вхожу в это присутствие,
I enter his presence,
разговариваю с ним.
I talk to him.
Я понимаю, что он слышит меня.
I understand that he listens to me.
Потому что он как ветер приходит.
Because he's like the wind who comes.
И я после этого все поменял в своей
and
жизни.
After this, I changed everything in my life.
Я сказал, я хочу этого.
I said, I want this.
И каждый раз, когда я тоже служу, люди переживают Божье присутствие.
And every time when I minister, people experience God's presence.
Но вот это присутствие,
but this presence,
когда я просто отдался ему.
When I just surrendered to him.
Я захотел этого.
I wanted this.
Я сказал, я хочу знать тебя живого.
I said, I want to know you.
Я хочу знать тебя реального.
I want to know the real you.
Не хочу верить в пустоту.
I do not want to believe in emptiness.
И потом я просто начал говорить с ним.
And then I just started talking to him.
Вначале это был монолог.
In the beginning it was one-way conversation.
Я не знал, что слышит он меня или нет.
I didn't know whether he listens, hears
me or not.
Я просто
садился и говорил, Господи.
I would just sit and talk to him.
Мне так хорошо с тобой.
I feel so good to be with
you. Я знаю, что ты слышишь меня.
I know that you can hear me.
Я просто хочу тебе говорить.
And I just want to speak to you.
Но я не просто хочу говорить, чтобы я тебе делился своим сердцем.
But I do not want to speak just on my own, so I would share my heart and feelings.
Я хочу, чтобы ты тоже говорил мне. И я хочу научиться слышать тебя.
I want to learn to hear you.
И тогда Бог начал говорить ко мне.
And then God started to speak to me.
Он начал говорить из его присутствия.
He started to speak from his presence.
Он начал говорить через Библию.
He started to speak through the Bible.
И это меня еще больше подняло.
And I was even more inspired.
Что говорит о том, что он живой.
Because it proves that he is alive.
И поэтому прошло уже больше 25 лет.
And it's been over 25 years
и у нас такие потрясающие взаимоотношения.
And we have such amazing relationship.
Он вообще не религиозный.
He is not a religious,
somebody
religious.
Он хочет говорить о семье.
He wants to speak about families.
Он хочет говорить о людях.
He wants to speak about people.
Я увидел его сердце.
I saw his heart.
Жаждущее исцеления каждого
his
человека.
Heart that hungers to heal every person.
Я увидел его сердце.
I saw his heart.
Которое жаждет спасения
that
каждого.
Passionate to save every person.
Как это произошло?
How did this happen?
Это через отношения.
It happened through relationship.
Не религиозные.
Not a religious relationship.
А когда ты начинаешь просто с ним дружить.
But when you become friends with him.
Вот это изменило всего меня.
It changed myself.
И поэтому я посвятил себя ему.
That's why I committed myself to him.
Поэтому, друзья мои,
that's why, my
может
dear friends,
быть, ты сегодня в какой-то религиозной форме.
Maybe today you are practicing a religious form.
Ты знаешь о Боге много.
You know a lot about God.
Но тебе надо познакомиться с Ним
but
лично.
You need to meet Him personally.
А как познакомиться
how
с Ним лично?
Meet Him personally?
Это отдать свое сердце.
To give your heart.
Где ты скажешь
it's when you say,
по своей вере.
in your faith.
Бог, я хочу знать тебя лично.
I want to know you personally.
И тогда он ворвется в
твою
жизнь. Может, ты переживешь его присутствие.
Maybe you will experience his
прямо
presence,
телесным образом.
In physical way,
что поменяет
way.
Тебя.
Maybe it will change you.
Но когда ты переживешь Иисуса,
but when you experience Jesus,
это не оставит тебя прежним.
It will never leave you the same.
Это изменит всего
it
тебя.
Will change the whole you.
Всю твою систему ценностей.
The whole system of your values,
всего
your value
тебя.
System, the whole you.
Оно будет менять тебя изнутри.
It will change you from
inside. И от этого очень тяжело отказаться.
And it's very hard to say no to this.
That's amazing. Pastor Vladimir, would you agree to pray for those who say, I would love to receive Jesus. I need to be saved. I need a savior. I'm living in sin and I want to repent and I want to experience what you just shared because I need God. Would you agree to pray for them and to help them to give their life to Jesus?
Да, Жан-Люк, перед тем, как я начну молиться,
Jean-Luc, before I begin to pray,
я хочу сказать еще одно свидетельство,
I would like to share a testimony,
как я оставлял грехи в своей жизни.
The way I left sin in my life.
Мне никто, я вообще не хотел оставлять грехи.
I did not want to leave sin behind.
Мне нравилось, как я живу.
I liked the way I lived.
И я боялся к Богу прийти.
And I was afraid to come to God.
Потому что мне надо оставить грехи.
Because I thought I need to leave my sin. I need to get rid of this first.
Но когда я познакомился с Иисусом,
but when I met Jesus,
у меня желание возникло оставить грехи.
I had a desire to get rid of my sin.
Они стали для меня помехой.
My sins became hindrance to me.
Они стали для меня обузой.
They became like a burden to me.
И поэтому мне хотелось их скинуть.
That's why I wanted to throw them away.
Поэтому человек, который, каждый человек, который меня спрашивает, вот мне обратиться к Богу, мне надо тогда оставить грехи.
So when people talk to me and they say, oh, I need to come to God, but first I need to get rid of my sins.
Я говорю, переживи Иисуса лично.
I tell them, first experience
и тогда
Jesus.
Ты побежишь оставлять
and
грехи.
Then you will run away from your sins.
Это
you will
для
leave
тебя,
them behind.
Это для тебя станет желанием.
It will become your desire.
И тогда у меня возникло желание.
And this is how I had a desire.
Я стал оставлять вредные привычки.
Living bad habits.
Потому что так сильно влюбился в Иисуса.
I was so much in love with Jesus.
И поэтому прямо сейчас
that's why right now,
ты можешь это сделать.
You can do the same.
Бог так любит тебя.
God loves you so
Он
much.
Отдал свою жизнь.
He gave his life for you.
Именно за тебя.
For you,
каждого, кто нас слушает.
For every person who's
чтобы,
listening to
чтобы
us,
пережить с тобой
so he can experience with
взаимоотношения
this relationship.
И облегчить твою
and
жизнь.
So he can make your life easier.
И поэтому прямо сейчас
so right now,
ты можешь повторить эти слова молитвы за мной.
Words of prayer after me.
Дорогой Господь Иисус,
dear Lord Jesus,
я признаю, что я грешен.
I admit that I'm a sinner.
И поэтому прошу тебя,
that's why I ask you,
прости меня.
Forgive me.
Сегодня, Иисус,
today, Jesus,
я прошу тебя,
I ask you,
чтобы ты пришел в мою жизнь.
That you would come into my life.
Я принимаю тебя в свое сердце,
I receive you in my heart,
как своего Господа и Спасителя.
As my Lord and Savior.
Я еще не знаю тебя,
I don't know you yet,
но я хочу знать тебя
but I want to know you
лично.
Personally.
И поэтому войди в мою
that's
жизнь.
Why enter into my life,
стань моим Господом.
Become my Lord,
и стань моим Спасителем.
And become my Savior.
Я не хочу верить в религию.
I do not want to believe in religion.
Я хочу верить в реальность тебя.
I want to believe in the reality
и поэтому
of
дай
you.
Мне пережить тебя.
So let me experience you.
Спасибо тебе, Господь,
thank you, Lord,
за то, что ты умер за мои грехи
that you have died for my sins,
и воскрес из мертвых
that you have resurrected from
для
the
моего оправдания.
For my righteousness,
с сегодняшнего дня
so, since today, since
ты
now on,
мой Господь.
You are my Lord.
Спасибо тебе, Господь,
thank you, Lord.
Во имя Иисуса
in Jesus
Христа.
Name.
Аминь.
Аминь.
Аминь. My friend, you are live on this weekly Hope and Healing. We just pray for the people who are maybe, they don't know about God, they don't know about Jesus, but they were willing to give their life to Jesus. If you have done this prayer that Vladimir did, I would love to encourage you. That's just the first step of what God is willing to do for you. First of all, we pray that the Holy Spirit now may come over you, that you can experience this greatest miracle called to be born again. In Jesus' name, receive the peace, receive the joy, receive this eternal life, the forgiveness of your sin, in the name of Jesus. And as you open yourself to Him, He's just coming, cleansing you from all your sin, giving you a brand new life. And through the Holy Spirit, the power right now, you are becoming a child of God, a son of God, a daughter of God in Jesus' name. Based on your declaration, I take authority over every demonic spirit. I set you free from every darkness, every suicidal spirit, death spirit. Leave your body and your life in the name of Jesus. And receive Him. And as you receive Him, I want to encourage you to read every day His Word, which means the Bible. You can download on every computer for free. You Google, you put Bible, and you can just download it for free. Read it. It's God's Word. He's willing to speak to you every day, not only for your spiritual life, but also for your daily life as a father, mother, or as a businessman. Many business people are watching. I want to tell you, we are praying for you. But don't forget, there is God, and in Him, you will find solution for your business in this season. And God is not only the God for the business people, He's the God for everybody. You can pray also. I want to encourage you to read the Bible, pray, and find a local community. If you don't have it, just go to YouTube and you will find some wonderful church like the Church of Vladimir. Pastor Vladimir, do you have, do you do on YouTube your church?
Да.
Yes.
Is it in Russian only or is it in English?
Есть часть на английском, но по-русски.
Partly in English, but most of it is in Russian.
So, and what's the address? How can we find that?
Мы сейчас вам пошлем.
We will send it to you.
That's wonderful.
KCLC.
So put Vladimir.
KCLC.ru.
Okay, you get this address. Say it again.
KCLC.ru.
And you will find all the information on that. Or you just put on YouTube Vladimir Ashev and you will find information. If you are speaking another language, God will lead you and I'm sure you will find a good community. And as soon as possible, when the confinement is done, go face to face to meet your brother and sister, learning to worship God, to serve God together, and to bring the good news to your friends as well. Now we are going to pray for the sick, because Jesus is real and He is never changed. He's not only the Savior, but He is also the healer. And for all those who are just joining, again, welcome to this live stream. It's a weekly life, weekly hope and healing, where God is moving in a powerful way. We have so many testimonies of people getting touched. Actually, I just saw in the chat a testimony. It's Tineke who wrote, "I'm healed. I've been healed last year by Jesus too from brain damage that caused epilepsy and paralysis. So yes, He can. And in meantime, I've seen many testimony of that in people's lives." A wonderful testimony of a lady who has been healed from brain damage and epilepsy, totally free, and she is in good health. So my friend, God can do that for you. Also, when God touches you, be sure to share your testimony. Write us, go to the ministry of IHM, write to healing-ministries.org, write your testimonies to give God's glory, because it's so important that we can hear what God has done for you, and it will give faith for the others. But also you can go to my Facebook or Instagram, where I'm sharing the testimony of what God is doing. And if you just go to my Instagram page, I post that every week. I post it. There is a testimony. It's written that I'm living in the USA, able to say that Jesus is the healer, as He healed me from cancer stage 4 in 1992. Today, I'm still healed and alive to tell everybody to believe in Jesus. Powerful testimony. God is healing the cancer. That's the reason we are going to pray for you in a few minutes. Another testimony. that I put it, and that's really God is moving everywhere in every nation. So I'm living in Moldova, suffering from tuberculosis since many years. During the prayer, as we do today, I felt a warmth coming over me, invading my lungs. Instantly, the pains left, and I'm totally healed, able to breathe perfectly without problem. That's what Jesus is willing to do today. Pastor Vladimir, would you say a few words to those who are sick, how they can receive their healing today? And then we will pray.
Прежде всего, я хочу сказать о надежде.
First of all, I would like to share about
Мне
hope.
Так нравится эта программа.
I really like this TV show.
Как она называется?
The way it is called.
Сила надежды.
The power of hope.
Нам никогда нельзя терять надежду.
We should never lose hope.
Надежда, она дает тебе энергию.
Hope gives you energy.
Был такой ученый,
There was a scientist,
которого зовут Курт Ридл.
His name is Kurt Riddle.
Он однажды проводил опыт над крысами.
Once he was making an experiment over rats.
И он брал крысу и опускал ее в сосуд с проточной водой.
He would take a rat and he would place it in a vessel with running water.
И крыса жила 15 минут.
And a rat could live for 15 minutes.
И все они умирали после 15 минут.
And all of them would die after 15 minutes.
Но он
minutes.
Решил на 14-й минуте ее поднять.
But he decided to lift up the rat on 14th minute.
И когда он ее поднял,
And when he lifted up the rat,
и опустил тот же самый сосуд с проточной
and
водой,
he put this rat into the same vessel with water.
Крыса прожила 60 часов.
The rat lived for 60 hours.
15 минут и 60 часов.
15 minutes and 60 hours.
И этот опыт его удивил.
And this experiment surprised him.
Что дало ей энергию?
What gave the rat energy?
И он пришел к такому выводу.
And he came to a conclusion.
Что то, что он поднял ее на 14-й минуте,
When he lifted up the rat on 14th minute,
это вселило ее в надежду.
It gave the rat hope.
И поэтому он сделал такое заключение,
So he made a conclusion,
что надежда
that hope
дает нам сумасшедшую энергию.
Gives us extraordinary or crazy energy.
Поэтому никогда не теряй надежду.
That's why never lose hope.
Надежда в исцелении
Hope in healing.
Она всегда есть.
There is always hope.
И поэтому сегодня,
so today,
может, ты прошел различных врачей,
maybe you went to see different doctors.
И, может быть, много что тебе не помогло.
And maybe many things did not help you.
Но надежда умирает последней.
But hope dies last.
И поэтому сегодня
so today,
будет исцеление.
There will be healing.
Как женщина, которая страдала кровотечением 12 лет.
As the woman who was suffering from bleeding,
Марка 5 глава.
For 12 years in
она
the
истратила,
Mark, chapter 12,
она истратила все состояние.
She spent all her possessions
на врачей.
She spent it for doctors,
на различных людей.
For different people.
И ничего не помогло ей. Но одно у нее было. Это надежда.
Hope.
И поэтому, когда она увидела Иисуса,
so Jesus,
она сказала, я прикоснусь
she
к Нему.
Said,
это моя надежда. И эта надежда переросла в веру. И поэтому, когда она коснулась
so
Иисуса,
Jesus,
Иисус почувствовал,
Jesus felt,
что его кто-то коснулся по-другому. И поэтому
way.
Он остановился. И поэтому я верю, что сегодня Бог будет касаться тебя каким-то особенным образом. И ты получишь свое исцеление. Поэтому никогда не теряй надежду. Молимся.
Shall we pray?
Amen. Thanks so much for sharing that. For those who are joining, you are live. It's a live stream, a weekly live stream called Hope and Healing. Where we do believe that God is real, is alive, and He loves you so much. And not only is looking for your soul and your spirit, but He's willing to heal your body. And that's the reason right now we are going to pray for the sick. Just put on the chat what you are expecting. We are willing to pray for you. Also, if you write to our office, we want to reply every prayer request. We read it, we pray. With a team, with ourselves, myself, we do pray for this prayer request. And then we reply to you. We answer to every prayer request. And even if you write, we are ready to send you a prayer cloth where we pray over it and we believe in the anointing that will touch you. So write us, but right now, God is willing to touch you right now. Pastor Vladimir, please just pray and I will flow with you and we will pray together for the sick.
Прямо сейчас, Господь.
Right now, Lord.
Мы приходим к Тебе.
We come to you.
Во имя Иисуса Христа.
In Jesus' name.
Воскресшего Христа.
In the name of the resurrected Jesus.
И Библия говорит,
the Bible says,
что ранами Иисуса
that by the blood,
мы,
by the wounds of Jesus,
мы были исцелены.
We have been, healed.
Ты заплатил за исцеление
you
каждого.
Have paid for the healing of each
и прямо сейчас
and right now,
мы высвобождаем это исцеление
release this healing
над каждым человеком,
over every person,
кто нас слушает,
who is listening
кто нас
right
видит
now, who can see
и кто
right
будет
now,
слушать
and who will hear us
во имя Иисуса Христа.
In Jesus name,
я провозглашаю исцеление
I declare healing
каждому человеку
to every person.
Прямо сейчас
right now,
Иисус
Jesus,
коснись каждого
touch each one of them
особенным образом
in a special way,
во имя Твое
in your name,
чтобы каждый человек
so that every person,
он пережил Твое присутствие
would experience your presence,
и пережил Твою силу
would experience your power,
силу исцеления
the power of healing.
Спасибо Тебе, Господь
thank you, Lord,
за то, что Ты слышишь нас
that you can hear us,
и отвечаешь на наши молитвы. И прямо сейчас
right now,
я чувствую у кого-то глаза,
eyes,
и вы чувствуете, как глаза чешутся.
You can feel that your eyes
Бог исцеляет чьи-то глаза.
God is healing somebody's
прямо
eyes
сейчас я
right
чувствую,
now,
как исцеляется у кого-то желудок.
I can feel that somebody's stomach
потому что
is healing.
Я чувствую, что сейчас у меня огонь в желудке.
I can feel like fire in my stomach.
И я чувствую, что кто-то, кто нас смотрит, исцеляется желудок.
And I can feel that somebody who is watching us is getting
также
healing
ступни,
for his stomach.
У кого-то проблемы со ступнями.
And also foot. Somebody has problems with feet.
И вам было тяжело наступать.
And it was difficult for you to stand.
Бог касается вас прямо сейчас.
God is touching you right now.
Я чувствую, у кого-то голова горит.
I can feel somebody's head is on fire.
Я не знаю, что там было.
I don't know what happened.
Но Бог исцеляет вас.
But God is healing you.
Я прямо сейчас чувствую, что у кого-то есть вы боретесь с раком.
I can feel right now that somebody is struggling with
прямо
cancer.
Сейчас
right now,
мы запрещаем всякому раку
we forbid any cancer
быть в этом теле
to be in this body.
Во имя Иисуса
in
Христа.
Jesus name.
Прямо сейчас
right now,
Дух Святой коснись
Holy Spirit touch,
и исцели во имя Иисуса.
Heal them in Jesus name.
И я прямо сейчас всякая опухоль да, упадет во имя Иисуса.
And right now, any tumor die in Jesus name, or go away.
Полное восстановление
I proclaim complete healing
каждое тело
into each body.
Во имя Иисуса.
In Jesus name.
Дух Святой, касайся каждого
Holy Spirit, touch each
особенным
person
образом.
In a special way.
Дай людям пережить Твою полноту.
Give people, let people experience
дай
your
людям
wholeness,
прикоснуться
your
к Тебе
let people experience
и получить свое исцеление.
And receive their healing.
Также я чувствую, у кого-то проблемы с позвоночником.
I can also feel that somebody has problems with
я не знаю, что произошло.
I don't know what happened.
Возможно, это какая-то авария.
Maybe it was an accident.
Или что-то произошло с вами, вы упали куда-то.
Or something happened, maybe you fell.
И вы повредили позвоночник.
And you damaged your spine.
И боли вас тревожат.
And now you have pain.
Прямо сейчас
right now,
я чувствую, как Дух Святой
I can feel that
он касается вашего позвоночника. И вы получаете исцеление во имя Иисуса Христа. И также поясница. Очень тяжело нагибаться вам. Вы испытываете боли. Бог касается поясницы сейчас. Ранами Иисуса мы были исцелены. Дух Святой, двигайся и являй Иисуса. Иисус настолько заинтересован в исцелении каждого. Кто-то со слуховым аппаратом. У вас слуховой аппарат. Вы где-то на 70%.
Maybe 70%.
Вы слышите.
You can hear only 70%.
Вы можете вытащить слуховой аппарат.
You can take this off.
И прямо сейчас
and right now,
я приказываю уху открыться
this ear to be opened up
во имя Иисуса Христа.
In Jesus name.
Прямо сейчас
right now,
просто вытащите слуховой аппарат
take away your hearing
и попробуйте
and try.
просто попробуйте.
Just try to hear, to listen.
Потому что слух возвращается
Because
во имя Иисуса.
Your hearing is coming back to you in Jesus' name.
Прямо сейчас.
Right now.
Сейчас еще у кого-то проблема с печенью.
And also somebody's having problems with the liver.
Вы много раз обращались к врачам.
You went to see many doctors.
И печень разлагается.
And your liver is destroying.
Прямо сейчас Иисус подходит к вам.
Right now Jesus is coming to
you. Я чувствую, как печень горит.
And I can feel that your liver is on fire.
Иисус касается вашей печени.
Jesus is touching your liver.
Во имя Иисуса Христа. Исцеление в Его лучах.
Healing is in His
rays. Дух Святой, спасибо Тебе.
Holy Spirit, thank you.
Великий и всемогущий.
Great and almighty.
Каждый человек.
Every person.
Каждый человек.
Every person.
Пусть будет исцелен.
May every person be healed.
Потому что ранами Твоими
Because by your wounds,
мы были исцелены.
We have been healed.
Спасибо Тебе, Господь.
Thank you, Lord.
Во имя Иисуса.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now I would love to encourage you to start to do things that you couldn't do. If you are not able to move, start to move. Check what the Lord is doing. God is the healer. The presence of God is here. So start and report, write us, or go to the chat, write what God is doing. But I pray for those who wrote also a lot in French, beaucoup ont écrit en français. J'aimerais vous inviter ce soir à 19h, j'ai un live Espoir et guérison en français et j'aurai un invité extraordinaire, spécial, qui est médecin et psychiatre et qui prie pour les malades. Donc rejoignez-moi ce soir sur le Facebook ou YouTube de l'IMG ou de Jean-Luc Traxel Ministère à 19h. Sorry my friend, I was just doing that because I saw many people who are writing in French. And but also people who are writing from Italy, Canada, Austria, so many countries who are following. So we want really to pray for the specific need in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God, for this eyes trouble in Jesus' name. Fanny, be healed in the name of Jesus. I command this articulation to Mary to leave. Every pain has to leave this. The heal in the name of Jesus, receive your healing right now in Jesus' name. I pray for Denise who is suffering. My friend, you are the friend of Denise, has a bone cancer stage 4. I just read this testimony of this lady also from the US, because you are from the US, as I think the Lord is willing to touch you in Jesus' name, not by mind, not by power, but through the Holy Spirit. Receive your healing in Jesus' name. Somebody wrote, wash hands, I don't know what that means. If you need a healing in your hands, be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for Ludovic who is suffering from multiple sclerosis. In Jesus' name, receive your healing, Ludovic. I break this demonic sickness and I pray for you in Jesus' name. Just for those who are following, we are live to a hope and healing. It's a weekly live stream where we are speaking about hope, where we can find in God, which His name is Jesus, because He's the only way, the only truth. And if you never gave your life, today you can give it. Just call upon His name, repent of your sin, and He will give you His life. But we believe also for healing. And I pray for Elena. I'm reading all the chat. Thanks for those who write on YouTube, of my YouTube or the YouTube of the Healing Ministries or of Facebook. I pray for Elena who is asking for Alexander who is 10 months old. He's a baby and has a brain damage. Lord, you just give this testimony through Tineke who wrote that she was healed from brain damage. We come in faith with Elena. You have done that for this lady, Tineke. I pray you can do that from this baby. Jesus' name, I command this brain to be healed. In Jesus' name, every trouble has to leave. I pray and I ask in Jesus' name. I pray for Michelle. Touch her right now. Visit her, Lord God. I pray for all those who are writing, many in French. Stomach problem, be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for Lynn, who has a back problem, be healed. I pray for Crystal, who have insomnia. Receive the peace in your night in the name of Jesus. Clad, who is suffering from esophage, be healed in the name of Jesus. Also, I pray on, it goes so quickly, so many people are writing. I cannot follow all. God knows all these things. Let me just find back where it was, because it's coming so quickly. I pray, Lord God, for the strength of this friend. Touch him in Jesus' name. I break this demonic spirit of your life. Therese, be free in Jesus' name. Karen, be healed from your back problem. I pray for Ovidio, who have this sleep apnea and depression and insomnia and prostate. Be healed in Jesus' name. Sophie, be healed from your eyes. I command this cornea to be healed in the name of Jesus. Pastor Vladimir, many people are writing, they are suffering from depression. Can you pray for peace and healing on these people?
Отец, прямо сейчас.
Father, right now.
Я высвобождаю Божий мир.
I release God's peace.
Мир, который превыше всякого ума.
Peace that is higher than any understanding.
Я запрещаю всякой депрессии.
I forbid any depression.
Быть в этих жизнях.
To be in these lives.
И я прямо сейчас высвобождаю мир Божий. Пусть мир Божий наполнит каждое сердце. Пусть надежда будет в каждом сердце. Потому что все, что вокруг нас, оно проходящее.
Is passing through,
но твой мир,
but your peace
он вечный, он превыше всего.
It is surpassing
и прямо сейчас
right now,
я высвобождаю Божью силу,
I release God's power,
Божью благодать,
God's grace,
чтобы мир пришел
so that peace
в каждое сердце
into every heart,
во имя Иисуса
in
Христа.
Jesus name.
Аминь, аминь,
аминь. Amen. Receive it right now. Also, I pray for Arno. Regine is asking for his son Arno, who is suffering from autism. Receive the peace of God in the name of Jesus. I pray for Francine, who is suffering from the psychosomatic problem. Touch her in Jesus' name. She is speaking German. I don't speak German. Ich spreche nicht so viel Deutsch. But in Jesus' name, be healed. Receive you Heilung in Jesus' name. I pray for deliverance of Eden, Zoe, and Marina in Jesus' name. I pray for Sylvie, who is suffering for polyarthritis and hypertension and trouble in the skull, in the audition. Touch, Lord God, Sylvie. Heal her in Jesus' name. I pray for Karin, who has the problem of the gland over the throat. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Je commande à ces ganglions d'être guéris au nom de Jésus. Je prie pour Brigitte que tes genoux soient guéris. Je commande à ce cancer de quitter Thérèse au nom de Jésus. I pray for Gertie, who is suffering from leukemia since 10 years. Gertie, be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. My friend, there is so many people who are writing. Oh, there is a terrible situation. The friend, somebody lost his mom and he is in the hospital suffering from COVID-19. In Jesus' name, we break this power of this COVID. We break this sickness, this virus. We set you free as you are watching from the hospital. Be healed in the name of Jesus. And may the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of consolation, touch you as you lost your mom. In the name of Jesus Christ. Many other requests, but we have to finish. The time is over. Be sure to connect with us. You can call our prayer line for those who speak French or English, or to have a personal meeting on the healing rooms. Go to our website, healing-ministries.org. And also, if you want to receive the free, that's it, the address is coming down on the website, on the screen. You can write there or send your prayer request, and we are going to pray specifically for you. Also, I would love to send you every week for free a hope inspiration. It will give you courage. It will be a booster for your life. Just register to my website, jeanluctraxel.org, also to receive all the information of what we are doing. We arrive at the end. We really pass the time. Pastor Vladimir, one short word of hope. What would you say to those who are watching? Because we have to close, but just one word of hope.
слово надежды.
Никогда не теряйте надежды.
Never lose hope.
Если что-то не получилось
if
сегодня,
something didn't work out today,
это не значит, что завтра не
it
получится.
Doesn't mean that it will not work out tomorrow.
Всегда продолжайте идти.
Always continue to move forward.
Пока вы живете,
until you're alive,
всегда есть выход.
While you're alive, there is always a way out.
Поэтому надежда всегда пусть будет в вашей жизни.
So may hope be always present in your life.
Ищите возможности.
Look for opportunities.
Пусть будет у вас страсть.
May you have passion.
Всегда знайте,
always know,
что Бог на вашей
that
стороне.
God is on your
он
side.
Сильно любит вас.
He loves you so
и Он
much.
Заинтересован
and
в вашей жизни
interested in your life.
И в вашем исцелении.
And in your healing.
Поэтому пусть Господь вас
so
благословит. Мы очень сильно любим вас и верим за ваше исцеление.
Amen. Thanks for this word. I still see all these texts coming, and that's very painful for me because I am full of compassion for those who are suffering, and I see you are so many who are writing. But there is a testimony of Michelle who wrote, "I've been healed from cancer stage 4 since 1992, and God is willing to do it again." So if you are a cancer trouble, be healed in the name of Jesus. I pray for Karina who is suffering for thyroid. There is people who are asking for revival in their family. That's a good prayer. Receive the fire of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. I pray for Loic who is suffering from addiction of the alcohol. Touch him, set him free in Jesus' name. Daniela who is suffering from blood trouble. Therese who needs healing on his family. On the parents, touch them, Lord God. Lord, you see all these needs. That's the reason we do this life. Not to promote us, not to promote our life, but to help everybody to turn their eyes upon Jesus and to ask you, to call upon your name, to be saved, delivered, and healed. So heal the sick right now in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you, my friends. Thanks so much, Pastor Vladimir, and you interpret. We love Russia. Give our love to your country and your family, and hope to see you very soon. I know that you are doing some life also with IHM Russia. When did you start?
У вас будет прямой эфир из
Айчи. Да, они, когда мы начинаете? Уже скоро начинаем.
Very soon. We
мы
will
уже
begin very
сделали
soon.
Страницу YouTube
we канал. Already created a YouTube
мы
channel
уже
and
соединяем
a page.
Служение, которое людей, служение, которое двигается в исцелении.
We already unite people from, who move in healing.
И поэтому они пишут уже послания.
They already write messages.
Приглашают на этот канал.
They invite people to our
для
channel.
Того, чтобы двигаться.
So that we can
и поэтому
move forward.
Мы уже стартуем скоро.
So we will start very soon.
Wonderful. So go to the Facebook or YouTube of IHM Russia, like it, and you will receive the information. The same if you do, those who are following on YouTube, just like it, the channel, and you will receive all the information of the coming meetings. I meet you the next week. Next week, we're going to have this hope and healing with George Kahl, but it's going to be on the evening, the 27th of January at 9 p.m. Also, right, we will have a Global Miracles and Healing Services the 13th of February with Matthäus van der Sint. Go to our website or to our social media and you will find all the information. To finish, I would love and encourage you to exercise your generosity. We do that for free. It's a free live stream. It's a free program. And we are not looking to make it pay because it's free. But if you want to help us to pay for the different things that cost, for the cost, we would love to invite you to be part of IHM and to be generous. And today, everything that you will give, we want to give it to bless Pastor Vladimir. So be generous and that we can be a blessing for Russia and Pastor Vladimir for Russia. God bless you. See you very soon. And never forget, there is hope in God. God bless you.
this place, I worship you. I worship you. In the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God.
Just not singing this beautiful song. We just know that Jesus is the miracle worker.